Welcome to our daily devotion. The Methodist Church of Barbados invites you to sing, pray, and worship with us as we declare God's glory and celebrate His mighty acts.
Hour of prayer that calls us from a world of care and bids us at our Father's throne make all our wants and wishes known. Creator God, Heavenly Father, we bless you, we praise you, we adore you, we magnify your holy and matchless name. Father God, this evening, we come, dear Heavenly Father, with grateful hearts, giving you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise that belongs to you. Father God, we lift your name on high. Father God, you deserve the highest praise. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, we welcome you in our presence. Fill every sacred space in our homes this evening with your power. Take complete control of this devotional time with you, O God. For the honor and the glory belongs to you. Father God, receive our praise and adoration in the name of Jesus. Most gracious and merciful Father, we come this evening confessing our sins and shortcomings. We have failed you, O God, in so many ways. We have not loved you as we ought to, and we have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have left undone the things we should have done, and have done instead those things we should not have done. Forgive us, Lord. Forgive us, Lord, for taking without giving, and for reaping without sowing. Father God, forgive us when we failed you by not responding to the needs of those around us. Father God, forgive us for not allowing our lights to shine in this dark world of sin. Forgive us the times we failed to evangelize Jesus in our conversations. Forgive us, gracious Father, for our sins and shortcomings, and restore us to the joy of your salvation, and strengthen us, O God, to do your will. In Jesus' name we pray. Most gracious and loving Father, from you all blessings flow. You're the giver of all that is good. All good gifts come from you, O God. We thank you, O God, for your love. We thank you for your mercy and your grace. We give you thanks, gracious Father, for blessing us with good health and strength, family and friends, food and clothing and shelter. Gracious God, we give you thanks for Jesus and for the precious cleansing flow, his blood, which flowed from his veins on Calvary's cross. We thank you, O God, for salvation, which is rich and free for all of us. Thank you, Lord, this evening that we're able to say boldly that we have been redeemed by the precious blood of the Lamb. Thank you for the church, which is our home of grace. We thank you, O God, for all of the men and the women, dear God, you have called for such a time as this, in this new season of change, this season of reset, dear God. And we pray, O God, blessings over each and every one of them. We ask, O God, that you would give them loving and compassionate hearts, that as they go out to serve their God, that as they minister your word, that as they perform other duties, their God, in the body of Christ and outside of the sanctuary, O God, that it would be all to your honor and your glory. We pray, O God, for the multimedia team that enables, dear God, every continent to receive the word of God. We thank you, O God, for all of the families represented through these your ministering servants and through all those who are bowed before you at present, O God. Father God, we thank you for your tender mercies, which are renewed each day. Great is your faithfulness towards us. As you continue, O God, to be faithful to us through your blessings, may we be a blessing to others. And may you continue to use us, O God, for your honor and your glory in this part of your vineyard. Give us thankful and loving hearts to serve you and to serve others. In Jesus' name, we pray with thanksgiving. Gracious God, we pray for all of the young men this evening. We recognize, dear God, that the young men, many of them, are falling through the cracks. Father God, they are reaching out in love. They are hurting. They need someone, dear God, to help to pull them back, dear Heavenly Father. But this evening, oh God, as we place them before your throne, we ask, oh God, that you would touch them in a wonderful and a mighty way, oh God. Father God, that you would resonate in them, dear God, goodness and love and temperance, dear God. Father God, encapsulate them in your arms, oh God, this evening. May they know, God, that they are special in your sight. May they know, dear God, that they are loved. Father God, we ask your blessing and your protection over them. We pray, oh God, that they would learn conflict resolution, that they would put down the guns and the knives and all the weapons of destruction, oh God, and turn to you, oh loving Lord. Father God, we pray for parents and for guardians and all those who have the care of children, that they, oh God, will live lives that are the children and the young people are able to emulate, oh God. And Father God, we pray blessings over all children and young people as well. For they too, they have their challenges. Father God, their challenges within the school and outside of the school. Their challenges within the home circle. Father God, there are all forms of abuse that is being meted out to them. But Father God, we pray for their release, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We pray, oh God, for healing for them. Healing for their minds, dear God, that they will not hold any malice and any hatred against the perpetrators, dear God, but they would know the love of Jesus, oh God. This evening, oh God, we rebuke the works of the enemy and we trample him under our feet this evening. And we say, oh God, enough is enough. You can't take our children from us. They belong to us. They were given to us by our loving Father. And so, Father, this evening, dear God, we yield them to you. And we yield them, dear God, for your blessings over them, for your protection over them, for your guidance and for your direction, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father God, we pray for all those who are sick, that they will be healed and restored to good health. And we pray for all those who are mourning, that you would comfort them, O God. And bless the peoples of the world, dear God, as each and every one of us continue to go through these challenging times. We yield it all to you, O God. We commit all to you this evening, O God. And ask, O God, that you would take full and complete control. In Jesus' name I pray with thanksgiving. Amen and amen.
Christ the solid rock I stand. The scripture reading is taken from Romans chapter 10, reading from verse 1 to 17. Brothers and sisters, my heart's desire and prayer to God for them is that they may be saved. I can testify that they have a zeal for God, but is not enlightened. For being ignorant of the righteousness that comes from God, and seeking to establish their own, they have not submitted to God's righteousness. For Christ is the end of the law, so that there may be righteousness for everyone who believes. Salvation is for all. Moses writes concerning the righteousness that comes from the law, that the person who does these things will live by them. But the righteousness that comes from faith says, do not say in your heart, who will ascend into heaven? That is, to bring Christ down. Or, who will descend into the abyss? That is, to bring Christ up from the dead. But what does it say? The word is near you, on your lips and in your heart. That is, the word of faith that we proclaim. Because if you confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For one believes with the heart, and so is justified. And one confesses with the mouth, and so is saved. The scripture says, no one who believes in him will be put to shame. For there is no distinction between Jew and Greek. The same Lord is Lord of all, and is generous to all who call on him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. But how are they to call on one in whom they have not believed? And how are they to believe in one of whom they have never heard? And how are they to hear without someone to proclaim him? And how are they to proclaim him unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. But not all have obeyed the good news. For Isaiah says, Lord, who has believed our message? So faith comes from what is heard, and what is heard comes through the word of Christ. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Blessed evening, brothers and sisters. I pray God's Holy Spirit be with us as we continue in this act of worship. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable to you, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. In the passage of Scripture taken from Romans chapter 10, 1 to 17, and written by Paul the Apostle, he realized that the people needed salvation, which comes from the righteousness of God and not from the righteousness of the law written by Moses. For we are no longer under the law, but under grace, the grace which is in Christ Jesus. Paul says the word of faith brings salvation, which is a free and gracious gift from God. Today, we proclaim this same word of faith, that if we confess with our lips that Jesus is Lord, and believe in our hearts that God raised him from the dead, we shall be saved. Repentance is the first step in order to receive salvation. It is when we confess our sins to God, ask for his forgiveness, believe in our hearts that Jesus is the Son of God who was raised from the dead, and accept him as Lord and Savior. This redemption is through the shed blood of Jesus on Calvary's cross. And we receive it by God's love, grace, and mercy. We receive salvation by grace through faith and by the power of the Holy Spirit. God sacrificed his only Son to die on the cross to pay the penalty for our sins. Romans 5 verse 8 says, "But God proved his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." This is the divine love of God, that matchless love that he has for us. John chapter 3 verse 16 tells us, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life." Salvation is the work of God's grace in our lives. That work is the saving of our souls from sin and its consequences. For the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Romans 6, verse 23. "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not your own doing. It's the gift of God," as we read in Ephesians 2, verse 8. Jesus' sacrifice on Calvary's cross assures us of our salvation. It is by faith in our hearts that we accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior of our lives. Salvation is secured and is for all. It is for all who believe and accept Christ's invitation, which is a gracious offer to us. Verse 13 of the text tells us, "For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." The scripture says no one who believes in him will be put to shame. God makes no distinctions. He is the same Lord of all. Salvation is a process, and grace is the undeserved favor or love of God is necessary for it, and faith in our hearts is necessary for it. By the power of the Holy Spirit, We are enabled to walk in ways that are pleasing to God. For our sins are blotted out, and we become children of God. An inward transformation takes place in our lives by the Holy Spirit working in us. We are converted to the image of God through His Son Jesus. And now we are turned toward God. With our sins forgiven, we are now justified by faith and have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Romans 5, verse 1. Conversion is the only route to salvation. When converted, you become spiritual, and your heart and life radically change. A gradual process takes place, and this leads to sanctification. In Matthew chapter 18, verse 3, Jesus said, "Unless you change and become like children, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. You must have childlike faith and humility." God's justifying grace saves us from the guilt of sin and restores us to His favor. The sanctifying process now begins, and at the end, you are able to love God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself. With this pure heart, you can experience the fullness of God's Spirit. You can continue to mature in Christ by faith as you grow in God's grace by daily prayer, fasting, studying the Word of God, worship, sharing in the sacrament of the Lord's Supper, time with God, and fellowship with others. Our lives can become a reflection of God as we grow in the knowledge and love of Him. So faith comes from what is heard, and what is heard comes through the Word of Christ. Brothers and sisters, let us in the mission keep on working in God's vineyard. Jesus said in Matthew 9, verse 37 and 38, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into His harvest." Jesus came to save sinners. Jesus told His disciples, "Repentance and forgiveness is to be proclaimed in His name to all nations." Luke 24, verse 47. Jesus came to set sinners free. So we must also proclaim the love and forgiveness of God. He has called us to be His witnesses and to follow His example and let our light shine in the darkness. Jesus is the light of the world. He is the comforter, waymaker, miracle worker, healer, and promise keeper, who loves us with unconditional and indescribable love. He has sent His Holy Spirit to be with us always, so that we may keep our faith strong in Him as He guides us in our walk with Him, as we share the good news of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you for being a part of our daily devotion. We trust it has been a blessing to you. Now together, let us hold fast to His word, and may it dwell in all of us richly.